This is a brief demonstration of how to download a Keyman IPA keyboard mapping program so that you can type an IPA in any program you want to. It runs on a platform that's called Keyman, so the first thing to do, type in Keyman IPA, and you'll notice that it says SIL here. SIL stands for Summer Institute of Linguistics. They were the original ones who set up these IPA keyboards. It's now migrated to the Keyman application. The key thing to recognize is that there are two things here for Windows. One is if you already have the Keyman desktop app installed, then you can choose this one. I don't, so I'm going to choose this one, which includes both the Keyman desktop application and the IPA keyboard. So I'm going to click on that. It downloads as an installer, and then I'm going to run the installer. Install Keyman desktop. Start Keyman. Now, this is the tricky thing that I saw when I did this on another computer. It doesn't look like anything's changed. Here's the secret. There's a little thing that's just appeared down here, this thing that says ENG. This is the English keyboard. If I click on that, now you'll notice that I can choose my regular English keyboard or this undetermined IPA SIL keyboard. So I'm going to click on that. And I should be able to type the keyboard shortcuts. The keyboard shortcuts are set up so that you type a regular character like A, and then you type some kind of a hotkey. Equals is a common hotkey, and as soon as you type equals, then it turns into some kind of an IPA character. Notice how E turns into schwa, D turns into eth, T turns into theta, S turns into the long S character, Z turns into Edge, etc. So this is a quick and easy way to be able to type in IPA. It does take a little bit of practice, but if you start transcribing and you transcribe regularly enough, it becomes quite a bit quicker than any other method for typing IPA characters. Thanks for watching.